Hey everyone, welcome to another lesson. I'm John Gorby for Elmer Music, and what you heard me play there was a Travis Picking inspired blues riff that I think you all enjoy. It's great to pick up an acoustic or an electric guitar if you're in a jam session and just play something like this and have guys join you, or just play it by yourself. It's a lot of fun. What you're hearing is an independent bass line with a melody on top, a riff, and it sounds difficult, but it's not as difficult as you think. I think you're really going to enjoy it. I'm going to break it down, show you the secret right now. So the first thing you have to realize is that the thumb of your fingerstyle hand, we're using fingerstyle here, is going to be thumping along this pulse, okay, this quarter note pulse. So the first thing you might want to try doing, and I'm doing this off of an A note here. You can play this off of anything, of course, but what we're going to do is start on the A note here, 5th fret 6th string. What I'm doing is I'm placing my thumb right back immediately after striking the string, placing my thumb right back on the string again. Okay, now you can also palm mute back here as well, which is what I was doing. Helps with the separation, and it helps to give the illusion of two different people playing, because you're not getting the same texture off of both parts. You're getting a palm muted part, and then you're getting a part that's not palm muted. So this is all I'm doing for the bass line. Once you get this down and you have the idea of this down, it opens up to do a lot of other things with this style. Okay, a little bit more intricate things that are challenging, but this is the beginning right here. Okay, sounds pretty simple, right? All right, now the next part you're going to play is this. And that's all that is. So let me show you that part right now, and then we'll piece it together. So basically, I'm set up here in zone 4, all right? So the first finger will be at the 4th fret, 2nd finger, 5th fret, 3rd finger, 6th fret, and the pinky is going to be at the 7th fret. So what I'll do here, and that kind of goes out the window when you start to play the bass line, but it'll set you up, you'll know where you're going. The notes I'm going to play here will be 5th fret, 4th fret, back to 5th fret. Okay, I'll use a fingering as a guide, it'll be much easier. So it'll be on the 4th string, 2, 1, 2, 4, 2, 1, 2. Okay, and then 2, 1, 2, 4, I think I'm on the 4, right? Actually, I'm on the 2. 2, 1, 2, 4, 2. Then I put the 1 here on the 3rd string. And then put the 3rd finger out here on the 3rd string, alright? I'm going to include a PDF file for you as well. So this can get kind of wordy, right? A lot of verbiage. So as I go through, if any of it is a little bit confusing, refer to the PDF file, all right? And it'll have all the tabs in there and the notation, so you can check it out. So that's the idea. Now, how do you independently play both parts, right? I'm going to play it real slow, and we'll see if you can pick up on what I'm doing. Here it is. Here's what's happening. Everything you play in the riff or the melody is going to be either with the thumb, or it's going to be, which is on the downbeat, or it's going to be on the offbeat in between the thumb. And that's it. Okay? That's the big secret to this. So it's either going to be with it, I'll do this little exercise for you, it's either with it here, I'll place my 2nd finger on the 6th string, my 3rd finger underneath on the 4th string, in the same fret here, in the fifth fret, and I'll play this together. So it's either that, or like a seesaw effect, right? On the offbeat, or on the and, right? One and two and three and four and that's it. It's like digital formatting, ones and zeros. That's all it is. Once you understand that, and you can practice that a little bit and get the feel of that, I think you're going to find that when you go to play this blues riff, it's going to be a lot easier to play and memorize and play it consistently. So now I'm going to take you through it real quick. Again, follow along with the PDF, and I'll show you kind of what I'm doing as far as playing together, or playing my thumb, or just playing my fingers. Okay, so here it is slow. See if I can do this slow. It's kind of tough to do it slow, but we're gonna try. So here it is. Thumb, together, together, fingers, thumb, fingers, thumb, fingers, thumb, together, together, finger. And then the only other thing I'm doing here is I'm going back to the third fret on the sixth string, and I'm playing that note right there. Okay, so go through that a little bit more so I know exactly where my fingers are. That was it. So the end of that is just together, together, finger. Okay? Together, together, finger, thumb, finger, thumb, finger, thumb. Now together, I'm going to play the first and second finger down here with the thumb for that chord. Okay, again, I get the third finger, fourth string, fifth fret. Get the first finger, fourth string, third fret. Fourth fret. Say that one more time. Third finger on the fourth string, fifth fret. First finger on the third string, fourth fret. Okay? Like I said, it gets wordy, guys. Check out the PDF. Thumb. And on the offbeat, I keep the third finger where it is, but I put the pinky now at the sixth fret, third string. So I get this little melody up top. And of course, with the note underneath, I have that. Okay? Alright, so one more time through slow. Second time, I chose just to leave that out. You don't have to put it in there. You can just keep it stumping along if you want. Now, once that starts to feel a little more comfortable for you, go ahead and explore with different note choices. Maybe move the bass around a little bit. This is just over an A chord. It's all that is. If you do this in a typical blues scenario, you might want to move to the 4 chord, move to the 5 chord. If you know, your experience with that, go for it and give that a whirl. If not, just stick with the A and maybe try to move that around a little bit on those same set of strings. See what kind of sounds you can make. All right? So have fun with that, guys. I'll see you next time.